Hey guys, welcome to the Was Another Transfer episode. It's Christmas. I'd like to wish everyone a Merry Christmas out there. Thank you guys for all the support. The channel is growing and growing. But without further ado, let's get into our first story of the episode. Baroka FC have terminated Kaizer Chiefs targets Ndansane's contract. So the midfielder is currently a free agent technically, and rumors are about that Kaizer Chiefs are already trying to thresh out a contract with the 25-year-old midfielder. So let's get into the story and let's break it down. Baroka FC have reportedly parted ways with three players, including Kaizer Chiefs target Ndatsane, effective immediately. According to various reports from the Limpopo province, Ndatsane was shown the exit door after Baroka lost to Stellenbosch 1-0 on Saturday. Two other players were released alongside the midfield maestro, as the club announced on their Twitter. Further reports that Ndatsane had a fallout with Baroka management after turning down a new deal to renew his contract, which is set to expire in January 2020, which means Ndatsane only has less than 6 months, basically 5 months, on his current deal, and he'll be able to sign a pre-contract with any club of his choosing. So a current move to Kaizer Chiefs could be on the cards, but there could be a few pitfalls to this move, but we'll get into that later on. The player was subsequently stripped of his captaincy after his relationship and the club's bosses took a strain. So he was stripped of his captaincy after refusing a new deal at the club. Ndatsane is one of Baroka's best players over the past three seasons, but he's been heavily linked with a move to Amakhosi during the past few months, which he has heavily denied. But I think this has taken a strain on the relationship between the player and the club. And I think behind the scenes, Chiefs could have been putting pressure on him or his representative. Thus, the player refused a new contract with Baroka. The left-footed player was nurtured at Naturena as a teenager. I didn't even know this, guys, but he was a former Kaizer Chiefs player in the development stages, and he left to Baroka, or he left Naturena for greener pastures to get more game time, or I don't know what happened during the development stages, but he already knows the club. He knows what the club is about. He was brought up in the way of Amakhosi, so he'd be a great addition to the Kaizer Chiefs project. With Kaizer Chiefs flying so high at the moment, it would be a no-brainer, because I mean, Chiefs will be able to give him a bumper contract then he would be able to earn at Baroka. Because I mean, let's not get it confused. Chiefs can offer him way more money than Baroka can ever. Here's the tricky part of Ndatsane getting into the Amakhosi midfield. Guys, as you know, that the current midfield three in, or the current midfield four within Coach Ernst Mittendorp rotation, is Katande, Maluleka, Manyama, and Bakers. That's it. That's his current rotation. And there are players like new defensive signing Ghanaian midfielder James Scotty, still waiting to make his first start for the Naturena club. The likes of Spilile Changase, who have been really not getting the game time that they have wanted. Even other players like Drax Adriana Rimanana, who had to go out on loan at Black Leopards, with Changase being linked to follow his teammate suit. So this would be really difficult for the 25-year-old. Even if he does sign for Chiefs, where does he play? Unless Ernst Mittendorp has identified him as a player he would like to see integrate into his squad. Because I mean, Katande is aging, Maluleka has 6 months on his contract, so maybe Mdatsane could be a target for Mittendorp, and Mittendorp wants him directly to integrate him into that midfield 3, midfield 4 rotation that could work for Kaizer Chiefs. But other than that, it will be really difficult to get him into the squad. Guys, please leave your comments and tell me what you think of the move. Mdatsane moving from Baroka to Chiefs. Remember, he is a former Amakhosi development player, so he's just returning home. He's coming back home. So leave a comment down below, and let's move to the next story. Sticking with Kaizer Chiefs, this is a rumor that seems to be sticking around, that Lorenzo Gordinho could be facing the exit door in January at Amakhosi, because he's currently out of favor with Eric Matoho and Cardozo really locking down those center back positions. So Gordinho could be looking for some more game time outside of Amakhosi. But guys, you wouldn't guess who could be in for Lorenzo Gordinho. Let's get into the story and let's break it down. Pirates could snap up Kaizer Chiefs outcast. Orlando Pirates could be looking to sign the Kaizer Chiefs player in the upcoming January transfer window. The Buccaneers have endured a bad first half of the season, as their defense have conceded 21 goals in 14 EPSA Premiership games thus far. Pirates have long been linked with Bidvest Wits and Bafana Bafana skipper Tolani Kwatshwayo, but their first choice has opted to sign a deal with the Students. They have now turned their attention to out of favor center back Lorenzo Gordinho. Lorenzo Gordinho, who's approaching his last 6 months on his current deal at Naturena, could have the chance to sign with the Ghost in the upcoming transfer window. No deal has been struck with the new center back at Amakhosi, and he has only played 118 minutes under new coach Ernst Mittendorp this season. The 25-year-old, who had a good run while on loan at Bloemfontein Celtic last season but has only been limited to 8 appearances after coming back to Amakhosi in 2019. As of the 1st of January, guys, Gordinho could be eligible to sign a pre-contract with any team of his choice, and the word is that the Buccaneers are keen on luring him to the other side of Soweto. Should the move materialize, this won't be the first time Gordinho finds himself at Pirates. Gordinho was on the books of the club during his development stages before moving to Kaizer Chiefs in his junior teenage years. Guys, this is something I didn't even know. Gordinho was a former Orlando Pirates player during his development stages, so when he was really young. But a move could be on the cards for Gordinho, because he really isn't getting a lot of game time at the moment at Kaizer Chiefs, but he's a quality player, with Mittendorp preferring actually a back three with Matoho, Cardozo and Sazman sometimes, or Frostler on the other, really depending. But I feel Kaizer Chiefs need to keep a hold of Gordinho just as cover, because he's really a quality player to step in. But at the same time, Orlando Pirates really need to address this center back issues, this defensive issues, and they really could lure the player back to the other side of Soweto. So Orlando Pirates could lure Lorenzo Gordinho from Kaizer Chiefs to the Buccaneers. Guys, please leave your comments and let's discuss this down below. Tell me, what do you think? Will Mdantsane move to Kaizer Chiefs? Is there even space for him? And will Gordinho leave Chiefs for Pirates? This is the end of the episode. Please comment, like, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next episode.